Joining us right now, Senator Pat Toomey, the only Republican senator who has announced thus far that he plans to vote no on the bill. Good morning to you, Senator.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
You are an outlier on this, at least at the moment. Tell us why.
Yeah, I hate to be the skunk at the garden party, but I think the actual substance of the agreement matters. And if you look at what they did, what they set out to do with NAFTA, and what they did, in fact, with USMCA, is they've passed an agreement that's meant to restrict trade. That was the idea, right? NAFTA is a free trade agreement. There are zero tariffs on manufactured goods, all of manufactured goods, zero tariffs on 97% of agricultural goods. So you had this free, fair, reciprocal trade agreement with no tariffs that had resulted in quintupling of American exports to Mexico, Pennsylvania exports to Mexico as well. And that was not acceptable to the administration because we nevertheless have a trade deficit with Mexico. And so they've gone through this whole process of, really restricting the ability to trade. So in my view, we shouldn't be going backwards. It was perfectly fine to do some of the updating and modernization that was necessary and appropriate. That's fine. But we shouldn't have put an expiration date on this thing. We shouldn't have put all the auto rules that are meant to limit Mexican auto sales. And we should have preserved the mechanism that allows negotiations to be arbitrated outside of a court system. So, in my view, we shouldn't be going backwards on trade. We should be going forward.
You're the only one, at least publicly on the record right now, Republican that is, who's planning to vote against this. Do you know of others?
I know of many Republican senators who have significant concerns. I don't know how people are going to vote in the end. And let's be honest. There's a lot of reasons one might vote for or against a particular trade agreement for a particular president at a particular moment. I'm simply saying the substance of this agreement is meant to limit trade, and I'm in favor of expanding trade, and so it moves in the wrong direction.
Do you have any concerns that if USMCA is not passed, that NAFTA at some point could be ripped up, as President Trump had threatened to do in the past?
First of all, the president has no legal authority to unilaterally repeal any law. And NAFTA is enacted through legislation. So the president doesn't have the authority to do that. And we shouldn't be cowed into voting for an agreement that diminishes trade based on a threat to do something the president doesn't have the authority to do.
But, Senator, it sounds from your last answer when we were talking about whether there were others like you who might be thinking about voting against this, that you're suggesting they are being cowed.
No, not necessarily. There could be any number of reasons, and I'm not going to speculate about the motivations of my colleagues, which I assume are good motivations. And it could include just a different interpretation of the agreement itself. I'm simply saying that, this is a big deal, and people could have many different factors in mind.
Hey, Senator, so let's say China. Let's just shift gears quickly. Right. China agrees to a first deal. We start making progress on a second deal. They start saying, you know what, we're going to come into the 21st century. We're going to stop doing a lot of this stuff with IP. All these things that we've wanted for so long start happening. You've been against tariffs all along in the whole approach to what's going on. Would you say, you know what, I was wrong. I'm glad we did this.
I have to correct you, Joe, because I have not. I have put China in a separate category because I recognize the behavior is different, the scale of the economy is different, and to my mind, one of the most important things is the geopolitics are totally different.
Were you for the tariffs finally then?
I've been in favor of the president confronting China. I've always been a little bit torn, frankly, by the use of the tariffs because we pay a price for that, but I've acknowledged that it was right to confront China, and I certainly hope the scenario you lay out is exactly what happens.
I don't know what the chances of that are.
I don't know either, but that would be the desired outcome.
Yeah, because there are a lot of people that the default answer is, I should have gone with our allies, we should have done it. It's just, the same crap from 25 years, and that's their default position,
And I have not been second-guessing the president about tactics here. There's, reasonable people can disagree, but the confrontation was necessary. Mexico is very, very different.
Senator, for the audience, to the extent that you have that view, that you make a distinction between the situation in Mexico and the situation in China, because
Mexico is a medium-sized country with a small economy, a poor country that's still developing, and the only competitive advantage they have is lower-cost labor. And as a result of that, there's one sector, the auto sector, in which They've been successfully able to export products to the United States. We've got a trade deficit with Mexico. Who cares? It doesn't matter. I don't know any reputable economists who think that's a problem. China is very different. One, the behavior they engage in, systematic theft of our intellectual property, is a totally different kind of problem. Also, I'm concerned about their geopolitical ambitions. I think the Chinese want to establish hegemony, certainly in Asia and the Western Pacific, and probably beyond that. It's an authoritarian regime that's extremely repressive, increasingly so, and they'd like to export a world order that serves them and not us. So China's just a totally different category.
Senator, always good to see you. Happy holidays.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you.
All right, coming